Hey, welcome in. Here's the headline. Microsoft pushing woke culture includes word checker to help you use woke terms. Grammar and refinements checks age bias, cultural bias, ethnic slurs, gender bias, gender-neutral pronouns, gender-specific language, racial bias, sexual orientation bias, and socioeconomic bias. And you better make sure to update that thing regularly, because you never know what the next worst thing in the world is going to be. In fact, actually, word checker, that implies there's right and wrong ways to do things. So I don't know, that sounds like white supremacy to me. I guess Microsoft better get on top of that. Maybe if they change it to word equity or something, that might be better. Because word checker, that could be violence. In fact, actually, the word violence is violence too, so they better get on that one as well. Let's see. In an apparent attempt to inculcate woke language into the verbiage of hundreds of millions of people, Microsoft has developed an inclusiveness checker in its Word software that would highlight phrases that might offend others. Although, you know, this could really be quite helpful. I mean, if I accidentally type something like, I don't know, fat feminist, it'd be really handy to have a program that would just automatically change that for me to like, I don't know, like brave and stunning, healthy at any size, other can, yes, queen, I guess. Yeah, I don't even have to worry about it. Microsoft's going to woke it up for me. Let's see. Some of the issues reportedly targeted by Microsoft in its latest version of Office 365, and 250 million people use that, includes age, ethnicity, gender, sexual orientation, or socioeconomic status. And here's an article from The Sun, and apparently they've given it a try. It says, users who wrote Mrs. Thatcher are told it may imply gender bias and are prompted to change it to the supposedly less offensive Ms. Thatcher. I wonder if Margaret Thatcher would have approved of this. I'm thinking she might not have. She might have thought it was insane. The phrase astronaut Neil Armstrong uttered when he became the first person on the moon is not deemed acceptable. Rather than one giant leap for mankind, he should have said humankind or humanity, because nobody knew what he was talking about before. But, you know, come to think of it now, there haven't actually been any women on the moon, have there? I mean, you know, I'm not saying, I'm just saying. But anyway, in the lyrics to Barry Manilow's party favorite Copacabana, Microsoft suggests Lola be referred to as a dancer, performer, or performing artist rather than a showgirl. Postman Pat is not gender neutral, so the system suggests calling him a mail carrier or postal worker. Even though, I guess, Postman Pat is a man. So Postman Pat, who's a man, can't be a postman. Remember when all this was just in the universities? It wasn't going to get out into the real world. It's just a bunch of crazy kids. Microsoft. Microsoft is doing this. Now, apparently this is an optional thing. You don't have to have this on. You can turn it off. So you don't have to play along with the cult if you don't want to, at least for now. I mean, the way things are going, it kind of feels like maybe this will just be like a permanent thing. Like you won't be able to use. There'll be words you can't write in a Microsoft Word because Bill Gates doesn't like it. Of course, Bill Gates will use any fucking words that he wants, of course, because he's Bill Gates. But is it really, is it that absurd? I mean, this in itself is so absurd that not long ago, people would not have believed you. This just would have been satire. This would have been a joke. This would have been something on South Park. It's just too ridiculous. So would I be that surprised if they removed the option of not using this? I really wouldn't be that surprised. Because you might have noticed that the left isn't really keen with people disagreeing with them or doing anything that they don't want. Is Bill Gates really a far leftist? I doubt that very much. I know what he's definitely not. He's definitely not a doctor or a scientist. What he is a ruthless businessman with a fairly obvious God complex. So I don't know about you, but I think that Bill Gates can take his woke 365, stick it in a syringe, and jab it up his God complex ass. Anyway, that's all I got to say about that. Please like, share, and subscribe. That really helps me out. If you just like to listen, there's the podcast version on pretty much every platform. If you look for it, you will find it. Thank you very much. I'll see you next time.